Man, that ice cream is good.
Yeah, man. Hey, you know what time it is?
Yeah, it's time to watch TruckerRudi.
We gotta go watch TruckerRudi.
Yeah, let's go.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, it is good morning. Yeah, we just got up and picked up our amped trailer, and here we are making our way towards our reload place. Yeah, I didn't want to get up too early because the place that we pick up at only opens at 8 o'clock, and well, you know, around that time there's always a lot of traffic, so I said, nah, I'm just gonna sleep in a little bit. And so here we are. It's 7:30 our time, but it's 8:30 Eastern time up here, so I said, you know what, I'm just gonna wait a little bit longer, because this place I can pick up anytime. It's no appointment time there. As long as I get there anytime between 8 and 3 o'clock this afternoon, I believe. So, it's only an hour drive from where we are right now if the traffic is good. So I said, you know what? May as well just leave now, and then that way we get there probably around 9:30 Eastern time, maybe 9:45. And by that time, you know, it's not as much traffic and all that good stuff. So, which right now it's not bad, you know. I mean, it's a little bit of traffic, but we don't have to slow down for it. They're actually still passing us, so that's a good sign. But anyways, we're on our way to pick up our reload. Once we are there and we know everything that's going to happen, then we're going to update our website, let everybody know we're going to go to Toronto. Yeah, I went and added a little bit of information about myself and details on my truck yesterday evening on my website as well. So for those of you that
I-675 North.
You can either look underneath my video in the description box for some of that information, or you can go to my website. You can find that information on my website as well. So either way, whichever way you go about it, you can find information about myself and about my truck details, what kind of engine I got, and all that good stuff. You can find all of that in the description box down below every single video. Or you can go to my website now and you can find it there.
Continue, so go ahead and do that. For 10 miles.
For those of you that don't know, my website is truckerrudi.com. So go check that out if you haven't already. We do keep that up to date all the time. And what we do on there is we put maps on there and tell you where we are heading to and stuff like that, so that way you can see more up to date on where we're going.
Ahead.
Generally, as soon as I leave in the morning, or you know, like, or let's say if I go on a trip like now, I go to my place, I make sure that I get the load, and then I update the website, so that way you guys know that that's actually going to happen. I mean, things can always change, but then I would update it. But I mean, that's what I try to do, is I try to keep you guys informed, so that way you guys know where we're going. And if you guys are on that road, don't hesitate to contact me, and we would love to meet up with you guys. And as you guys know on my videos, I'm 7 days behind, so sometimes, you know, you contact me, oh, hey, you know, would have been nice to meet up with you, blah, 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 you know. Well, if you look on my website, you can tell in advance that I'm coming into your direction, so you can, you know, contact me and we can definitely meet up. And if you don't check my website, well, then when you watch the video, it's going to be too late. I was there 7 days ago. But, yeah, that's the way it is. But, looks a little foggy or muggy or whatever out there, but it is real humid. Temperature is not that hot today, but it was real muggy out there, that's for sure. But anyways, we'll go pick up our load and then we'll go from there. All right, guys, we are loaded. Yes, indeed we are. Didn't take very long to get loaded over there, so we don't have a heavy load at all. Very nice light load, so now we're making our way down towards Toronto. Yes, indeed. Only one thing that we gotta do yet, and that is get through Atlanta, Georgia. Yeah, we kinda gotta go back towards that and then go up to I-75. So, I figured, well, perfect timing, I think. Anyways, I mean, it's Friday, but it's only 10 minutes to 11 Eastern time right now. So I think the traffic shouldn't be too bad right now. But we were pretty lucky there this morning, I think, when we, I think we went in the right time. Because now when we came out, like just where we had to take that exit, that's where construction was starting and was down to one lane only up there. And now when we came out, there was miles and miles back up on the way that we went in earlier, you know. So we got, we timed it just perfectly, I think, this morning to go in there and pick up our reload. So that was awesome. Now we got our reload and hammer down. Now we can start going to towards Toronto and have our master stick tomorrow night. Yes, indeed. We got 736 miles to Windsor border. Oh, we forgot to do one thing. That's we forgot to update our website.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, we forgot to do that. Oh well, I guess we'll do that somewhere down the road here. Once we get to it, we'll get that done and everybody will know where we're going. Yeah. But anyway, as soon as this car passes me here, we're going to get into the next lane over here. We're going to pass this FedEx, I think. Maybe not. Maybe he's picking up speed again. It was just going over the hill. He was slowing down a little bit. But yeah. So we're excited to go to Toronto, aren't we?
Oh yeah.
That's what I thought. We only got about 14 more miles to go up to 281 bypass there for Atlanta. But we're not too far away from Atlanta, so should be okay, I think, at this time of the day to go around there. So we'll hope for the best anyways. I hope they don't have a lot of construction on this side of the Atlanta. We went around on the other side yesterday and came back up on this side a little bit. So hopefully they're on the other side, on this, like on this side here, will be good too, you know. Well, we'll continue cruising along here and we will show you what we can. Alright guys, we told you earlier, as soon as we got into a rest area, we would stop, or as soon as we find one, we would make a pit stop and...
construction ahead.
We would update our website, so that's what we just did. We finally found us a rest area and there we are. Now we're actually leaving, but yeah, we just finished updating it. Oh man, this asphalt looks like it's breaking up over here in this rest area. But yeah, so we just updated a website. Now we can head back on the road again. Hopefully we can get through Knoxville before the bad rush hour starts. Because I know that's a fairly big city there too. So I know we can expect to see some heavy-duty traffic up there as well. Looks like we're about an hour away from there, maybe a little more, maybe a little less, I don't know exactly, but about that. So yeah, at least we got the website updated now, so everybody can go check it out again and see where we're going. Oh, look at that Smokey Bear coming through there, eh? Wow, he's sneaking through. He's gonna come right there from behind the bush and capture everybody. See what they're up to. Surprise them, right? Yeah, it's another hot day out here, it's for sure. Very humid, right?
Oh, yeah.
That's what I figured. That's what it felt like to me anyways. But at least we don't have that beating sun on us today. It's not really, the sun is not really peeking through, so at least we're okay in that department. But we will continue cruising along here. Don't know exactly how far we will make it, but we'll probably have another 6 hours, maybe even 7 hours of driving that we will do today yet. And then we'll make our way to Toronto tomorrow. Yeah, we still have 660 miles to the border, so we got some good miles to go yet before we get to Canada. But that's all right. We do get paid by the mile, so we make money when we drive. Sometimes, anyways, not all the time. If we can get good fuel mileage and we don't have any problems, then we can make a little bit of money. But yeah, that's the way it goes in trucking. Ready, guys? We are just coming up, just before Knoxville, Tennessee. Yeah. Chicken House is apparently open, so we gotta go in and see what they want from us today. Hopefully they won't want to inspect us today. It'd be kind of hot out here, so hopefully they'll give us the bypass lane. That would be kind of nice if they would do that. So, oh, that guy's got to go in, so let's see what they will give us. Give us the bypass lane. That is fantastic. Yes, indeed it is. I love it when they give us bypass lanes. Yeah, all permit loads go to the back. All right. I guess he wants to have a look at that container unit there, I suppose. They don't really have any signs to go here. So, oh, that's a nice cab there, eh? Look at that. What is that, a Peterbilt or what is that? It doesn't look like a Peterbilt. Look like something else. Kenworth?
I think so.
Looked like it, eh? Sure didn't look like a Peterbilt, so nice. Anyways, we are just about to hit Knoxville here, like I said, and it's 2:30 my time, but it's 3:30 their time, so yeah, probably gonna be a little traffic going through here, but that's to be expected at this time of the day, right? Yeah, you know, right?
Yeah. No, I didn't know.
Oh, you didn't know? Okay. Well, I think so anyways. That's the way it usually is in big cities. Knoxville is probably no different, but hey, look at this guy, how fast he's going. It says 55 mile an hour speed limit. I'm already doing 58. And look how fast he's just cruising right by me here, you know? That's crazy. Some people, they don't care about speed limits or the rules or regulations or laws. They just speed right on through, and then they wonder why we truckers have a bad name, you know, bad reputation. Because somebody screwed it up for the rest of us. That's generally how it works. But that's okay, I guess. Not okay, but that's the way it is. That's the way it works. It looks like we got another 11 miles till we will be on I-40. Then I think we run on I-40 for a little bit till we hit Knoxville, Tennessee. Yes, indeed. It it's another hot day out here. It was like 34, 35 degrees out here earlier, so it's a hot one, that's for sure. I'll be happy when it cools down a little bit more. I like summer, but not this hot. Yikes. Then I like to be on the beach somewhere, having me a cold beer, being short, sitting on the feet in the water, you know? Up in Canada where the water is cold. Yeah. Anyways, figured I would show you a little bit more on what we're up to and show you more as the day progresses. I got some awesome news for you guys, ladies and gentlemen. We are going to meet up with a subscriber of ours, it looks like, as of right now. Yeah, we got about 2 more hours worth of driving to do. I just contacted him. I was just making a pit stop here a few minutes ago. I was at the rest area there, first rest area, or one of the rest areas into Kentucky. Got a welcome center over there. And so I texted him on Facebook there, and he said, yeah, he would love to meet up with us. So so we're gonna go over to a truck stop a little bit further north from here, obviously, but hey, we're looking at possibly meeting up with him tonight. That would be fantastic. I haven't really met up with any new subscribers of mine, or he might, I don't think he's a new subscriber of mine. What I meant to say is, I haven't really met up with anybody that's a subscriber of mine in a while, especially somebody that's, you know, new. I met up with people that I've met up with before, but other than that, I haven't really met up with too many lately, so that's nice that I'm gonna get an opportunity to meet up with somebody. I know there was another person in Knoxville, Tennessee that I could have possibly have met up with, but he never got back to us on time, so we got through there, and I guess it's too late now, but hey, this person replied, and he said he would like to meet up with us tonight, so that's awesome news. I love that. I always love meeting up with subscribers of mine, you know? And he's gonna get to meet my son, right? Unless you're gonna be hiding in the bunk. You gonna be hiding in the bunk? No?
I don't think so.
You don't think so? Okay, then.
If he's too scary, then yeah.
Okay, all right. No, I don't think he should be scary. I don't think so. But yeah, that would be awesome. Finally get to meet up with somebody again. And I haven't really been down this area in a very long time either. I mean, I've been up on the area where we're going to be meeting up with not too long ago. But up on this stretch of the highway, it's been a very long time, if I ever even been up. Yeah, I believe I've been on this highway before. Because I remember going down this 75 before. And, or going up, basically, I guess I should say. But yeah, it's been a long time since I've been down this road, so it's a very rare opportunity that we get to meet up with subscribers in this area, you know. So I'm going to be really looking forward to meeting up with this one, that's for sure. I know he's always watching my YouTube channel, and I know the other day when we did a live show, that's the guy that was commenting on our live show, so that's going to be nice to meet up with him. At least we can, you know, he can get to know us and a little bit better, and we get to know, you know, people that are subscribed to us, and I always enjoy that, and I'm sure most of you guys enjoy meeting up with us as well, and really looking forward to that, so let's stick around for that, guys. We'll try and show you as much as we possibly can. It is very much time to go find out if we can find us a parking spot in this pilot truck stop up here on exit 129 up here on I-75. Matter of fact, they have 2 pilots out here. One is on the east side of the highway and the other one is across the road on the west side of the highway. Yeah, so you can choose which one you want. We're gonna go to the east side, gonna give that a try and see if we can find us a parking spot in there. If we do manage to find a parking spot in there, we'll go inside and grab us a shower.
In a quarter mile,
and we're planning on meeting up with somebody.
Cherry Blossom Way, and then keep to the right at 0.2 miles.
Here we go. Moment of truth will be known very soon. Another thing will be known very soon if the person will actually show up that's wanting to meet up with us.
Keep to the right on Cherry Blossom Way, KY620, and then turn left to 950 feet.
All right, RJ, you tell him. You just go ahead and tell him. Let's go take a look. It looks like there's plenty of room in there yet. So that's kind of nice.
In 700 feet, turn left on Tripport Road, and then turn
nobody
left to 850
coming over there,
feet.
So that's good. But it looks like there's still plenty of room in there. So I've been at this truck stop before. Only thing they got here is a Waffles. I mean, a RB's, I believe. But there's a Waffles there. Kind of looking around to see if they might have something else around here, maybe a better restaurant or something like that.
In 800 feet, turn left on Tripport Circle.
Maybe go have us a bite to eat
on the left side in 550 feet.
Yes, indeed. Let's see. He said he's going to be coming here with a 1986 Ford pickup truck, I assume it is. So let's go see. Just looks like some customer there. So we gotta go down here to go to the pilot. And that's exactly what we're gonna do, right? We'll find this
approaching
a good parking spot.
Approaching destination in 500 feet on the left side.
I guess we don't have much of a choice to eat in here. That's not much of a choice. We either Waffle House or Arby's, I guess. Maybe the other guy that's coming here to meet us, maybe he will know of a good place around here to eat, so...
You have arrived at your destination. On the left side,
yeah.
Pilot Travel Center number 353.
I think we're gonna go on the other entrance there. And then hopefully we can drive in somewhere. If not, we'll back her in somewhere. It doesn't matter, right? As long as we can find us a parking spot, that's all it really matters. I'm sure we can. Pretty sure we can. There is spots out here, but I don't really like to park backwards back in here, you know? I don't really like to do that, so we're gonna give it a try and hopefully we can get lucky somewhere. Get us a spot. Well, looks like every one of these has been taken that's been driving in. We'll go around and we'll see if we can find a spot on the other side. If not, we will have no choice but to park over here, but don't really like to do that, but I guess we'll have no choice, so. All right, guys, here we are at the pilot. As we told you guys earlier, or you guys saw us come in here. We had us a shower, right?
A good one.
Yeah, we had a good shower. Now, the goal is to find our subscriber. See if he's made it here or not. Not 100% sure if he made it here. I just tried to call him and wouldn't go through or something. I don't know. I tried twice and it wouldn't work. So I haven't seen him. He said he's got an old Ford pickup. So I'm gonna go check in the four-wheeler section over there and see if we can find him. Alrighty, guys, we are here at a restaurant and we have finally met up with. You want to introduce yourself?
I'm Terry Barnes.
Terry Barnes. Hey, yeah, we're here with my son. And what's this place called?
Georgetown, Kentucky.
Georgetown, Kentucky. But what's this restaurant called?
O'Charlie's.
O'Charlie's, eh?
O'Charlie's.
Yeah, that's nice. We've already had salads and stuff like that. We're just waiting on our food. I ordered some steak. There it comes. There it comes. Well, guys, let's take a look. We got our steak. Baked potato. You too, eh?
Oh yeah.
Yeah, that's right. Anyways, we'll go grab us a bite to eat and then we'll chat some more later on. Alrighty, guys, we are back in the truck here. Yes, indeed. And guess what? Don is still over here.
He's
Terry, yeah. I said Don, but I meant to say Terry.
I've been called worse.
Yeah. Yeah, anyways, so how did you like the meetup today?
I really enjoyed it. I've been wanting to meet you quite a while since I saw your first video.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's cool.
Glad y'all looked me up and pinned me and let me know y'all was on the way up here.
Yeah, appreciate you meeting up with us here and taking us over there to a nice steakhouse. And
yeah, glad to do it.
Yeah, that was nice.
We'll have to do it again when you roll through here.
Yeah, definitely, yeah.
Yeah.
How was steak for you?
Very good.
Very good? Yeah, I think we had a fantastic time. Yes, indeed we did. And I see you might be able to see, that's where we got our clips. We got our other clip over there. This is where this camera that I'm recording with right now is usually standing. And then okay. I got another camera here. I was just charging her up that I usually put right over here. Like that.
Wow.
And then that records everything, but yeah. So you live about 28 miles from here,
right? 28 miles in a little town called Frankfort, yeah. Kentucky, which is the capital city of the state.
Oh, cool, cool. Well, it was really a pleasure meeting up with you. I know you've been a very loyal subscriber to me. I know you watch on a regular basis, and
yeah, as an old truck driver, I still got to watch trucks.
How many years have you been driving?
I drove for 22 and a half years.
22 and a half, eh?
Yeah.
Wow, that is really a long, long time.
Yep.
I think we're gonna put the camera right here. There we go. Hopefully you guys can still see him. It's more about him today than it is about me. Yes. 22 years, eh?
22 years.
Wow.
Started out with J.B. Hunt.
J.B. Hunt, eh?
Started with him. And I drove with him a couple years. And of course, I was trying to figure out where I fit in at. So I tried a few other companies then. And
yeah.
My biggest one I stayed with was MS Carriers until Swift bought them out.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Wow. What kind of truck have you been driving most of the time?
Most of the time, the whole time, mainly cab overs. It'd be either internationals, of course, and freight liners. I drove Peterbilts.
Okay. Which one would you say is the most comfortable for you back in the day?
I want to say the International 9700.
Okay.
Yeah.
Was that one that had a dual shifter?
Dual shifter.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah. Dual shifter.
Wow. You've been going back a long time, that's for sure.
Yeah. Sure have.
Wow. No, I love meeting up with my subscribers, you know. I love hearing stories, and especially from truck drivers, you know. Like, most of mine is about trucking and stuff like that.
Right.
So it's always fun to hear from other truckers and what their stories are. And,
yeah.
I enjoy that anyways.
I mean, like I was telling you earlier, I wish we had all this GPS and other stuff when I was truck, because we could use it.
Yeah.
Saved a lot of tops off of trucks and everything. I mean, I've seen a lot of drivers that took the roof stop because they hit a low bridge.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Wow. So, I'm going to ask you on camera now, how did you discover my channel?
Well, be honest with you, of course, like I said, I'm an old truck driver, and a lot of times I get to where I want to drive a truck still, but you know what, we talked earlier, I can't.
Yeah.
Well, someone told me, said, go to YouTube and said there's a bunch of truck drivers on there. So I spotted a couple of them, and then I seen yours, and I seen something about the something dangerous video that you, the first one I saw you doing that I watched anyway, that about the driver on a two-lane highway was passing you and almost hit him, had an accident, mm-hmm. which was very dangerous.
Mm-hmm.
And I said, I like this guy. He's really telling the truth the way it is, you know. And,
yeah.
And I said, well, then I hit subscribe, and I've been a fan ever since.
Cool.
Yeah, and then I watch the others on there, too.
Yeah. No, I appreciate that if you know, watching my channel. And that's what it all is all about for me is meeting
right.
people and I really really enjoy when I can, you know, like talk to the people and
right.
And get their feedback and hear their stories in trucking, and that's a
yeah.
lot of fun for me.
Yeah.
And
the ones that wants to get into trucking, it's a good career, but you better do your P's and Q's before you come out here.
Yes. Yeah.
I mean, back when I, like I was telling Rudi here, it was back in the day when I had paper logs and we just pinned it on a road atlas. Now you got all this other stuff that really helps truck drivers out there, and it won't be as bad, but you just make sure that's what you want to do. You're going to spend a lot of time from home. You ain't going to be a billionaire overnight either. You just make sure that's what you want to do when you start trucking.
Yeah, so do a lot of research on
right. Well, I resource, watch Rudy's videos, the other drivers that are out there on YouTube. Check them out. If you got questions, I'd be glad to answer them.
Yeah, yeah. If you guys got questions, leave them in the comments, and we do try and get back to them, although I'm not always too quick on it. But
like I said, I'm on Facebook too. Like I said, I'm Terry Barnes. I'm in Frankfort, Kentucky, so y'all look me up there, and if you have any questions about trucking, I'd be glad to answer them as much as I can.
There you go. What are some of the most interesting trucking stories that you have as your trucking career?
Good or bad?
Doesn't really matter.
Well, there's always good stories.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, we was talking earlier how I enjoyed back in the day when we would, when you see a truck driver on the side of the road, about be about four or five right behind them to pull over and see what's wrong, if they can help. They can throw a wrench or two in there to help with the problem.
Yes.
Even back in the day when J.B. Hunt and Snyder was getting all picked on, if a J.B. Hunt or Snyder was on the road, broke down, needing help, or in trouble, there's a bunch of drivers right there to help that driver, no matter what.
Yeah. We don't see that a lot these days anymore.
That's true.
It's sad, but it does happen, you know.
Yeah, and I like to see the truckers stick together still.
Yes. Yeah, I would like to see that, but it's hard to see that these days. Like, they always joke around about it. It's hard to get three truck drivers to agree on something.
That's true. That is very, very true.
Yeah, yeah.
True.
So you said you've been up to Canada as well, eh?
Yes, only two provinces I've been in, was like I told you, was Ontario and Quebec.
Mm-hmm.
It's only two provinces I've been to. I always want to go to those, but never did get the chance to go up that way.
No, okay. So what has been your experience to go up to Canada? Was it a good experience?
Yeah, it's a good experience. I enjoyed it all. Of course, I liked Ontario better than I did Quebec.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I always went to Mississauga a lot, in Toronto, London, all Ontario quite a bit, Windsor.
Mm-hmm.
And just different places I went to. There's only a few places I've been to, just up north of Montreal a couple of times, but no big deal. But it seemed like Quebec, it seemed like they didn't want nothing to do with you.
No?
You know, so, but Ontario's different. It's just like people here in the States. They'll talk to you and be friendly with you and all that.
Yeah, yeah. What kind of trucking did you do? Did you do reefer?
I did reefer for a while, but mostly driving.
Mostly driving?
Yeah.
Have you ever done any flatbed or?
No, I never did flatbed.
Okay.
No.
Oh, cool. Cool. Yeah, that's quite a story there.
Oh, yeah. There's a lot of stories out there. I mean, if I had them all to tell, we'd be here till we have ham and biscuits in the morning. There's just a lot of good stories out there, and some stories I'd rather not talk about.
Well, yeah.
There's a lot of drivers I've seen losing lives too.
Yes.
With sad stories.
That does happen quite often.
It does happen. It sticks my mind to try. I try to forget. It is this bad crash where it's right there on I-40 on the interstate on the Texas and New Mexico line.
Oh, yeah.
Truck driver lost control, caught on fire.
Oh, my.
The driver got out, but his passenger was still in the bunk. We couldn't get him out.
Oh, my.
And that was one of the scariest and, I guess, the saddest part of my trucking days right there.
Yeah,
watching that. He's in there burning up, and I couldn't do nothing.
Yeah.
Nobody couldn't do nothing, really.
Well, yeah. That'd be hard.
Right.
That'd be very hard.
But those are always good stories, and a lot of times you will find drivers you run along with, talk on CB, and keep you up at night and whatever, and all that. Of course, back in the day, we was able to go ahead and run what we can, but now with these e-logs now, it's kind of a different story now.
Yes.
You can't run like you used to.
Yeah, you definitely couldn't. what are some of the things that you would recommend for a new driver that would want to get into the trucking and stuff like that? What would be some ideas that you would have about that?
Well, like I said earlier, make sure that's what you want to do. Mm-hmm. Make sure that you're going to know the good and the bad about it. You know, the pros and the cons. Mm-hmm. If you got a wife and a family, you know, discuss them how they're going to feel about it.
Yes.
But just make sure that you get with a good company and explain your home time to you. But it, you know, at least a couple of weeks. If you're going to be out a couple of weeks and be home a couple of days, that's great. That's good. That's good home time. Mm-hmm. And just keep on doing, keep in touch with your family mm-hmm. all the time. And also make sure that the you know, you keep in touch with your dispatcher, your company, everywhere you go, and make sure you keep in contact and keep things going.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
Like I said, just make sure that's what you want to do.
Yes, yeah. I know that's easier said than
right.
done. I know.
And if y'all looking for a lease purchase program, do your homework first before you do it.
Yes.
I mean, there's a lot of companies out there that wants don't care about you. They just want that money. That's all they want.
Mm-hmm.
They don't care about you getting enough miles or, you know, like that. They want you to get enough miles so they get money. They don't care if you get paid or not.
Yeah.
So you make sure that's what you make sure you check everything. Do your homework. Make sure there's no complaints again through the Builder Business Bureau.
Mm-hmm.
And make sure that their credit rating is good with the credit people. I mean, always do your homework. Do your research.
Yes.
I mean, you got Google and all this at your fingertips now. There's no reason to fall into a pit like that.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, yeah. No, I agree. What's your idea on women drivers?
I think they're good. Yeah, we had a lot of women drivers when I did drive.
Yeah.
And I didn't have no quarrels about it.
Yeah.
I was happy to see them out there.
Well, yeah, I am too. I'm just. Yeah. Asking you know, somebody that's been around a lot longer than I have, you know, what have you seen?
I've seen a lot of good drivers.
Yeah,
women drivers. I sure have. I've seen a lot of them.
Good.
A lot
that's,
of
that's
them.
Good.
I had sometimes, excuse me, gentlemen, but I've seen a lot of women drive better than a man.
Mm-hmm.
I sure have.
Yeah, yeah. Well, that's awesome. That's awesome to hear, man. That's it's always we're always looking for ideas and stuff like that, and you know, I love to hear stories, and from especially from somebody that's been around a lot longer than I have. You know, I don't have that many years of experience, and he certainly got me beat, that's for sure. And so I always like to ask for you know, questions on what was it back in the day and stuff like
right.
that. You know, it's I always have an interest in it, you know, like, I don't know if you know that I grew up in South America and stuff like that. Life was quite different than it is up here in North America, you know?
Right, right.
And back over there, you know, it was more like it was over here back in the old days, you know, where people helped each other or you know, you fixed a lot of the stuff yourself, like not like nowadays where you call road service or something like that and get it fixed, right?
Right.
And that was just, you know.
A lot of times you didn't have a
road service to call.
Road service, no. I mean, it's even long before the Qualcomm came out.
Well, yeah.
I mean, you had to get a driver,
phones, right?
driver, somebody take your next telephone to call for help.
Yeah.
Then you got to get a ride back to your truck.
Yeah.
Unless, you know, you find a place that's already got a, you know, wrecker service and a mechanic shop and stuff like that, and then you can get help that way. But lucky, one thing about the Qualcomm, when it first came out, if you had problems, a breakdown or whatever, you can just type it in your dispatch and they'll send you help. Just tell them where you're at.
Yeah. Well, that's what we got in here as well, and it's helped me at one occasion. I think I did tell that story a little while ago. Maybe last year, some time ago, I told that story a little bit where we were on that Highway 502 there, and we kind of broke down over there, and there's no cell service up there, and so we kind of had to use that. It was the middle of the night in the winter time, 40 below zero, you know.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it was a bad one there. That We just about froze to death, I tell you that much. But
anyways, I think we're going to hang her up for tonight. I hope you guys enjoyed our little meeting here, and we will say goodbye to you for now.
Alrighty. Bye-bye, and God bless you.
All right. Catch you guys later. It's time to get going. It's time to move on. Put this behind me. That day is gonna come.